What is going on, football world? Man, it's been so long since the last Nations League matches. In fact, it's been so long my beard grew back out. Give me a minute. Much better. Now let's dive back into the Nations League, shall we? So as you probably know, the Nations League finals will take place starting next Wednesday on the 5th, 6th and 9th of June. On the 5th and 6th we got the two semi-finals, and then on the 9th we got the two finals. On the 5th we got Portugal against Switzerland in Porto on the 50,000 seater, even though he had the record of 52,000 against Barcelona in 2003. On the 6th we got Netherlands against England in Guimarães in the 30,000 seater, the home of Vitória Guimarães. And then on the 9th we got the two finals, like I mentioned. The final for the third place will happen at 1500 Central European Time in Guimarães, and the final at 2045 in Porto. Now there are also some news bound to those finals. The headliner will be Cristiano Ronaldo returning for Portugal, as they announced it a couple of days ago. Switzerland are seen as the complete underdogs out of these four teams, but with that role they might just prove something. With beating Portugal they have a big chance on the trophy. The Netherlands on the other hand are seen as the shadow favorites, considering the talents of Ajax that came all the way to the Champions League semi-finals this year, and also their captain Virgil van Dijk, who might walk into the first semi-finals as a Champions League winner. The English team would probably want to compensate their World Cup run when they made it fourth place. Speaking of past runs, Portugal's record versus Switzerland is as follows. Out of 22 matches, Portugal has only won 7, 5 draws and 10 wins to Switzerland. Their last two meetings were in the World Cup 2018 qualifiers, where each team won 2-0 at home. And their last major tournament encounter was at Euro 2008, when Switzerland grabbed a 2-0 victory. In the other semi-final, both teams share an equal record with 6 wins each and 9 draws. Their last match happened in March 2018, when England grabbed a 1-0 victory in Amsterdam. Their last competitive encounter happened in 1996 at the Euros, when England was host, and also won 4-1 against the Dutch. You're probably also wondering how much money these teams make for competing in the Nations League finals. Well, you're lucky, because I'm gonna tell you that right now. Just for participating in the Nations League finals, each team is guaranteed 4.5 million euros. Third place is guaranteed 5.5, second place 6.5, and winner 7.5 million euros. Of course, I hope we get spectacular matches, no nil-nil draws, hopefully, and lots of goals. Well, that's kind of saying the same thing. Oh well. And like I said, I can't wait for the Nations League finals, of course. I have to also watch the European qualifiers for the Euro 2020, but you know, Nations League got a little more important since the introduction. Now don't forget to leave a like to this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you are new, and stay tuned until my next video, which will be right after the grand final of the Nations League, when I will be discussing the events that happened in those four matches. If you need someone else to watch though, check out my other channel, Football A to Z, where I present every FIFA association member in the world alphabetically. And tomorrow we're gonna talk about the Nations League participant of Andorra. So leave a subscribe over there as well. But that's it from me for today. I can't wait for Wednesday to come. And stay tuned for more Nations League content.